Hey, it's Noah, and welcome. I'm so glad that you're here, and I just want to take a quick minute to explain to you the background story behind TKIM, the kid in me, what it's all about, what's happening, who he is, what in the heck is going on, and why does Noah have a puppet in his studio? So, hey, this has been such a dream of mine and an incredible journey of what God's been doing in our business and in our family and in our life. I just wanted to like bring context and clarity to everything for you so that you can understand where we're at on this journey and how thankful I am that you're on it with us and what to expect and what we've got coming down the pipe. So bottom line, here's the deal. Back in 2013, the kid in me was born. The whole concept and the idea of taking your story, what did you want to be when you grow up, and bringing that to life in a painting. And I would actually sit down with collectors and take their information of what they wanted to be, how they acted that out. Did they, you know, build rocket ships and cardboard boxes? And did they build, you know, this whole idea of, wanting to be a fireman and building fire trucks and being a policeman or a doctor, you name it. We acted all these out in our imagination. And that was like the spark. And so I trademarked the name, the kid in me, here's going to be this brand. And that grew and grew into my events. And collectors started me painting their actual stories and bringing those to life. As a result of that, what started to happen was the next part of the journey was we then started forming partnerships, and Costco started carrying the kid and me actual images, and we started selling the art through them. And then from there, Disney started carrying the kid and me characters on merchandise, art, figurines, and it's just been an incredible journey seeing, you know, little Noah and the characters actually in my booth and in the merchandise, which has been phenomenal. And so the kid and me, we've done pins, we've done apparel, we've done all of these pieces of merchandise to be able to just see how it was going to resonate with you, the collectors and guests, just to find out, hey man, is this really taking hold? But the story and the narrative was what really birthed out of this. And this is what I'm so excited to talk to you about. Little Noah, this whole idea of the dreamer's pen. You can see the image behind me, which is the look of the whole movie poster and the episodes that are coming out animation-wise, developing our graphic novel. I've teamed up with an amazing, amazing writer and my partner, N.D. Wilson, Nate Wilson. You've seen his work on the amazing, he just does incredible work, on the amazing Hello Ninja series that's on Netflix. He's also done documentaries and children's books, and he just writes incredible, incredible work. And so all that to say is we've partnered together. He's written an incredible script for The Kid and Me, and it's called The Dreamer's Pen. This graphic novel will be dropping next year. We're in development on it now, just tightening things up, my illustrations and so on. And so this is the main character, Little Noah. And the whole goal here was I wanted to create a character. I was in this dilemma. I'm like, man, I want to do animations every single week to just like provide really cool strategies and creativity and like really great principles that are biblically based. They're going to help you live on purpose and lead on purpose. And so I wanted him to be the deliverer of that content, even though I do a lot of talking and blogging and videos. But I thought, wouldn't it be fun and a clever new way to provide inspiration in your inbox and on your social media that's going to happen every single week, but have it actually be him doing the talking? And an opportunity to hear the narrative of the dreamer's pen and what's coming out. So I had to kind of work my way backwards. And my thought was, hey, what if we drop the graphic novel next year at Comic-Con and work our way back and try to drop new merchandise, new narrative around certain parts of the story, and using him as the vehicle to tell that story. So that's what I'm super excited about. And I was always inspired by Jim Henson. And the fact that, you know, I was thinking, how do I go from either doing a sketch or doing full-blown animation? Is there some way that I could find a hybrid and something that was in between? And so that for me became where I could control a puppet, make him talk, and actually have this character come alive. And so we tweaked the voice, we tweaked the color, we tweaked the whole look, and we create that narrative of his own studio, him using his creativity. Now, I want to tell you two things as we wrap up here. One, why we're doing everything that we're doing. And two, kind of what the Dreamer's Pen is all about. So first, let's talk about the story, and I'm going to tell you why we're doing everything that we're doing. Noah, the Dreamer's Pen is about a 10-year-old orphan who is really, really amazing. And he has got some challenges, some disabilities, but he is absolutely like a savant. And he can totally use his gift of creativity, his pen actually, and he uses this pen to visit children and people in their dreams in the spiritual realm, in the kingdom. And he's able to go in there and help rescue them from the dominion of darkness, from their worst nightmares, shame, fear. And so he enters the world of Lerev, and that's the name of the world. And that's where he enters in these dreams. That's the dream world. Well, the RDS, the Robbers of Dreams and Souls, that's the villain that you see, these like raven bird-like characters with top hats and really gnarly. And they ride around on like these futuristic Harleys that are hovercrafts that are really cool, these bikes. And they basically want to shut him down because of the fruit that he is and the impact that he's having on people's lives. And it's taking over the kingdom and it's overriding their efforts. And so obviously they want to invade the real world and take him down. So all that to say, it's a thrilling story. It's a wonderful allegory for the kingdom that's going to help provide inspiration and hope and help people overcome their fears and their doubts and the interference that comes from the enemy so that they can step in to their unique calling. Now, what makes this so awesome with Noah is the fact that he is like a 50-year-old's wisdom trapped inside of a 10-year-old's body. So when he talks and when he gives drops and he's like talking about certain topics, you're like going, wait, dude, this like kid is giving me some serious downloads. And that's the hope. We want to have something not just for children, but for parents, because there's a kid in each one of us. Now, lastly, so that's the little dream. That's the dreamer's pen. And then we also want to talk about a little bit about what TKIM is all about. Well, some people definitely love wearing the kid in me because they love the brand and they love what the heralding the brand and the slogan is all about. But TKIM for me was a reminder. I wanted to have apparel, I wanted to have merchandise, and I wanted to have a lifestyle brand that backstops what Noah and this IP, this intellectual property, is all about. And that is what our mission here is. And our mission has always been, since the day I started at 16 on my bike, I want to use my gift of creativity and story to bring hope to the world. Creativity and story to bring hope to the world. It's literally on the apparel. But listen, it's to remind you to use your creativity and your story to impact the world. If we play small, if we stay hidden, if we don't take our creativity out to the world, your work doesn't get seen. It can't make an impact. And typically our creativity is a wonderful vehicle to take our hurts and our pains to use it as a solution for other people. So please step in to that risk. Please step into creating. And this guy right here is going to help provide you the encouragement and the courage to step into that on the daily. So my hope is to use this content to provide that encouragement to you and to others in the world. Well, the biggest and greatest news about this entire initiative is the fact of our relationship with Acres of Love, rescuing and caring for special needs orphans. And we do that through our efforts with Acres of Love, our partnership. You can see it on our website if you go to noahelias.net. And we're using the kid in me. And in Zulu, the word kid is translated to Ngani. So Ngani Forever Family Home is what we coined the first home that is caring for 6 children currently right now that we have in our care, that we use the proceeds from the art that sells and the product and the apparel and everything that we're doing. We're using these efforts to help underwrite that kingdom initiative. And we want to sow that love and that care into those children. There's 3.5 million children that have been orphaned due to AIDS. And we especially have a heart for those that have been orphaned as well as special needs. And so special needs has hit our home, and we want to be able to take that need, and we want to be able to use these assets, the wonderful stories that we have with the kid in me, the apparel, the products, the art, the courses, everything that we're doing. And we want to be able to use this story to help spread hope throughout the world. So I appreciate you just spending some time with me, but I want to let you know, when you hear this guy start talking, there's a reason behind it, and there's a reason why he knows what he knows, and there's a reason why he's living so much on purpose. And so he's going to encourage you to live on purpose. Thanks for watching, and we're really excited to start doing some talking, and you'll see the first episode, which is all about the comparison trap. We're looking forward to being in your inbox. Thanks for doing life with us. And remember, if you see it on one of our shirts, we are in your corner. See you later.